paid to. So I'm cleaning up. But I decided to come to y'all because I was having a conversation with somebody. You know, hashtag whatever gets you talking to your girl, Connie. I've been busy, y'all. I haven't been out here because, you know, that 12 to 9 shift. Man. But I passed my last exam because the other one before that I didn't pass. But I was coming because I was talking. Okay, so my daughter has autism, right? And I was talking to a lady. And we were talking about it because I was like, I know that with me having, trying to have another kid, like, well, I'm not trying, but if I were to have another kid, I know that the likelihood of my next kid having autism is, you know, higher because I have the first child who has autism. And I was saying that, you know, I still believe that it came from the vaccination that she had right before she turned 2 years old. Because she got, like, a flu shot and some other stuff. And the lady was telling me, like, that she doesn't believe that my child received, you know, that she got autism based off of a vaccine. But I'm the mom. You know, I watched my child and asked how she developed before she got vaccinated and the way that she developed thereafter, you know. And I'm like, you know, it's been a lot of parents with kids with autism who suspected that it has something to do with vaccines. We can't prove it because, you know, with medicine, it's something hard to fight. But we're basically guinea pigs, you know what I'm saying? But because she's basically like, her baby didn't get, you know, autism from being vaccinated. But, like, what does that even mean? You know, I understand she probably was saying it to try to convince me that that couldn't have been the case, but what does that even mean? And yes, my hair's like this is because, you know, I'm about to crochet it. But anyway, what does that even mean? Like, just because, let's say it was shellfish, right? I'm not allergic to shellfish, but maybe you're allergic to shellfish. So if you eat shrimp and your face swells up, can I be like, man, it don't have nothing to do with shrimp? Because I ate it and I was fine. Like, that's, you know, that doesn't even make sense. So, like, because my baby, I was a stay-at-home mom. So, and my family, we have a lot of kids. So, she was developing fine. And then she just didn't. It was almost like she was reset. And I was like, she was reset by about 2 years, which she was almost two. Then when I did take her to get evaluated, she was 2 years behind. But, I mean, she didn't start off 2 years behind. She was, you know, she was walking at about 10 months, you know, it's normal. And she was talking. She was saying her ABCs, you know. Before she was one, she was speaking. But then, after this, she became like a little echo. Like, echolalia. Like, everything I would say, she would say the last thing what I said. Like, she wasn't developing the same. Like she would just be spaced out, and it's like she really basically just kind of stopped talking, like almost like she didn't want to communicate that way. It became pointing and things of that nature. Now she speaks a little bit more. Now she's older. Now she's 9, but it's not to the stage of like a 9-year-old. Like, she can answer questions except whys are questions that seem to baffle her. I can ask her what and where's, but if I ask her whys, it's like it throws her off somehow. But of course, being a parent of a child who has autism, you learn to communicate in a different way. But I'm like, I still believe that this was the source, because this is not what happened. So, and it's like, it makes me think that if I was to have another child, and then I think too, when she turns 11, I think she's supposed to be receiving some more vaccinations. But I'm like, I'm afraid to get her vaccinated again, because I think they gave her a lot of her vaccinations early, because she hasn't had any vaccines since, like, maybe she was about 5, I think. And I'm like, I'm afraid to even try to get her vaccinated then, because, like, I don't know what the outcome could be for that. And then if I was to have another kid, I wouldn't want to get that kid vaccinated. I was told by someone, like, if you don't get your kid vaccinated, then your kid can get my kid sick. But then it's like thought bubbles. If your child is vaccinated, doesn't it mean that your child is supposed to build up an immunity to this, which means that your child should be able to combat this? If anything, my child would get the disease from your kid, because your kid has it, just in a weakened form. Because all vaccines are weakened formed of something that is telling your body, like, it gives you a weakened version of something, and your body It's supposed to build up its defenses and fight it off so that if this ever comes up again, your body knows how to combat it. Because the biggest of like defense against any disease is your body and how you take care of it. So where's my kid going to get it from if everyone is vaccinated? Like, where is it coming from? Like, where is my kid getting it from if all of these people prior to have been vaccinated? That's the thing that I don't understand. Like, where will my kid get it from? And how will my kid give it to you if your kid's immune to it? Like, that doesn't make any sense to me. But it's like, and it's not one size fits all, but that's what medicines are. They're one size fit all. They give all of these hundreds of thousands of people this one type of vaccine. And it's like, you don't wear the same size clothes as me. You're not the same height as me. You know, if you get glasses, they're not going to be the same prescription as mine. Like, you know, my bra size is not your bra size. My panties aren't the same as yours. Like, so why is it one size fit all? Why isn't it like this people over here, maybe they get flu vaccine B and they over there get flu vaccine A1 or flu vaccine B2 or something? You know, like, why is it all the same one size fits all? So that if my kid is allergic to the shellfish that you put in that vaccine, this person over here is going to say, well, it must have been something wrong with your kid because my kid didn't have a reaction to it. Like, that doesn't make any sense. I know when we talk vaccines, people get all in their feelings about it. So let me know what you all think about it. I'll make some more videos. I have a little bit more time. It's the holidays, so I'll probably just try to throw a few things in. But let me know what your opinion on it is. Because, like, I don't see how not vaccinating your kids would be an issue and why people even feel so strongly about it. But then too, like, a person who doesn't have a kid with autism would tell me that they don't think that's the source when they never actually have to deal with the situation. So you can see me on Twitter, ConnieB9, and of course hashtag whatever gets you talking here, truth and love and hate on YouTube. When you guys come back, I should have my hair finished. Right now, I'm going to try some little faux locks. I'm going to finish cooking and cleaning up. Talk to you all later. Bye.